What were your biggest reasons that you decided this is the team that you wanted to stay with, besides the back?
I got a bigger bag somewhere else.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I decided to, Lou Will was a big factor, I'm gonna be honest. Mm-hmm. It's like a brother to me, him and Trez, and I felt like, you know, my legacy can, you know, I want to reach Gary Payton, that defensive player of the year, and I want to get that, and, you know, I thought in order to get that, I had to go with the Clippers, and that was the best role, yeah.
Who offered you more money, and how much more money?
3 years, 50 from SAC.
Interesting.
Yeah.
And you just were like, I got to stay where I am.
Got to. No disrespect, and I appreciate SAC, of course, but, you know, like, you know, all good money is good money.
So how do you see the Clippers next season? No Golden State full team next year, but if you guys don't get Kawhi, how do you see your team next season?
We'll compete. We're going to compete at the highest level, you know that. We're going to play extremely hard, and we're going to make the playoffs for sure. And, you know, you get to the playoffs, it's all about seeding and all about who you match up with, and we take care of that from there.
So one of the interesting things about the Clippers pursuing Kawhi is one of their big pitches is this is about as well-run an organization culturally, infrastructurally, and whatnot, that this is actually a place for a top player to come set up shop, hone their skills, achieve everything they can as a professional. I'm just curious, like, because the Clippers, before you got there, like, not a great history, but that's how they see themselves now. I mean, is that persona correct?
That's absolutely correct, top to bottom. You know, and I never like to, you know, downplay any other team in L.A., but, you know, medical team, coach, players, top to bottom, you have to go with the Clippers. You have to. I mean, it's ownership, and it's no disrespect to anybody else, but, you know, top to bottom, they do the right things consistently, all the time.
I mean, Scotty, did you see that low-key shade, though, that he just threw? He was like, I don't want to disrespect anyone else
actually,
in L.A.
I was going to ask him, what is he doing to recruit Kawhi, but
well, there you go.
He just answered
everything.
He just
everything. Did some of it.
Yeah, right here on our show. Great job.
Very strategic.
Right? I mean, that is something I assume the organization is selling. Are you doing anything to recruit Kawhi Leonard? We've heard LeBron maybe actually participating in these free agent meetings, certainly talking to Kawhi. Have you guys reached out from the player side?
Nah. I mean, I just think that, you know, if you're a player in this league and you played against us, you know what we bring. We go play hard and we go leave it on the line. You know, you want to go, you know, glitz and glamour, that's fine. You know, you want to come and get your hands dirty and do some dirty work. You
know? that's sort of the interesting thing about this year. It used to be everybody, you'd get a suite at the Montage, teams would come in with their presentations. This year, it seems like we're past that in the league.
Yeah.
And at least my interpretation is, you guys know what you know.
Yeah.
There's not a lot that a GM or an alum of that team or a famous player can come in and persuade. I mean, you know, in some ways, who was it who said, I'm not going to be recruited? I mean,
yeah, Kevin Durant.
Like, you guys know what you know. And when you walk into those free agent pitches, are you at a point where your intel is so thorough that you got enough guys you can call and talk to?
Yeah, I mean, of course. Like, for me, and it was all respect for the Clippers, but I didn't even have to meet with them. I knew exactly what they brought to the table. I knew the medical staff, the coach, and, you know, Doc, and the players that were there. So, you know, I made my decision way easier.
Yeah, gave up $10 million apparently, so that's a decision right there.
It's a great decision. Yeah. All the best.
Oh, thank you.
Absolutely.
I
want to move on to around the league and get some of your opinions, Pat, because I want to talk about Ben Simmons and the Sixers. Philadelphia and Simmons have until October to finalize a rookie extension, but Woj reporting the two sides are very near a projected 5-year, $170 million extension. Simmons averaging nearly 17, 9, and 8 in a season that saw Philly come, just a Kawhi 4 bounces away from potentially advancing the conference finals, maybe even further. Pip, I'll start with you. Does this deal put more or less pressure on Ben Simmons? Because the sentence that follows Ben Simmons is always like, and he needs to develop his jump shot.
Well, I mean, that's the story that's going to follow him probably for the rest of his career. But to say that, you know, he didn't deserve this contract, I would be wrong. But he has a lot of work ahead of him. Yes, the pressure has turned up, not only from the home fans, but on the road, people are going to continue to make him show that he deserves that salary. And that's just part of our game. The big stars, the guys that make the big money, they step up and they are the big stars at the end of the game. So he has to continue to work and develop his game. Obviously, Philly believes in his work ethics and, you know, where he can go from here. But he has a long road ahead of him, because someday I'm sure they see him as a leader of that team. And you got to be able to shoot the ball.
Totally agree. I mean, and, you know, and especially in this the new NBA, you know, you call it, we pay you all that money when it's a tie game in game six, and 4 minutes to go, I mean, you know.
Yep.
Can you give me a bucket?
Yeah.
You know, can you give me a bucket? And if you can't, I mean, you can be rich, but what about your legacy? And I think that's important.
Yeah.
Can you get a bucket when Patrick Beverly is guarding you?
Nah.
That's
Kevin Durant did.
But I don't think we can sit here and point our fingers at this kid saying he can't shoot the basketball and that he's going to be a bad basketball player going forward. He may not never be able to shoot the basketball. He may not never develop a three-point shot. All of his other skills will continue to get better, and I think he brings a lot of value to the game and a lot of strong points at what he does do best.
Yeah, for me, the interesting about this is the moment where Philly is no longer playing with house money. You know, they were a nice surprise. They got in the playoffs. They won a round.
Right.
This season, they sort of, you know, justified their seeding. And I think this almost symbolically says, look, now you're on the clock. Like the process is over.
Right.
This is now, you were designed to contend, you were being compensated to contend.
Yes.
And whether it's with a jump shot, without a jump shot, that this is now the moment where Philadelphia has to achieve expectations.
As a player on the floor against Ben Simmons, I know you guys only see him twice a year. Scottie points out, I mean, he's so crazy talented in so many ways. What do you do when you are trying to defend him?
He's tough. He's a tough cover. Just his size and his speed, and just the fact that he can play make, and the coach does a great job on putting him in positions to be really good. So, I mean, the contract is much deserved. But you know, for me, if it's time to get a bucket at the end of the game, you know, on that team for Philly, who do you give it to? You know, and that's the big case right now.
Well, you know your guy who left to go to, I mean, he didn't leave, he was traded to go to Philly, Tobias Harris.
Yeah,
the big contract he signed, and I think part of the expectation there is that he's going to be one of the guys they will go to get a bucket, especially now that Jimmy Butler's not there, right?
Yeah, and I have to say this because he's my friend, but I lock him up too, though.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.